It's Pablo's Wrap of the Week.
This week, I thought it was about time to get some money for a housing deposit, so I rang AFL legend Dermot Brereton. Throughout the series, you often said that you found it hard to ask people for cash to help you win the challenges. I don't, yeah. Dermy. I don't at all. And I was wondering, me and my girlfriend are saving for a house deposit, so if you've got a bit of cash lying around, do you want to shoot it my way?
Yeah, okay. You're going to have to let your girl come and stay with me for a month. How does that sound?
I'll give you the bank details and everything off air, all right?
I'm sure she'll be rapping you. You've just hired her out.
It's fair to say this sparked a bit of controversy, especially with Rourke Walsh.
When I'm getting text messages from your girlfriend, you know there's something wrong. It's never okay.
Dermy seems pretty keen to me, Rourke.
Fair to say he was. Jeff, not so much. You know, there are certain ways of acquiring a house in life, and selling your girlfriend off to another man is probably not the best way to go about it.
The thing is, I don't earn the big bucks, and I know for yourself, you know, you're on big money up there in big water in Kununurra. You've got the house. You did go half with your parents, but we won't go into that, how much you are, you know, a bit of a mother's boy, but we won't go into that. But you do have the house. Now, I don't have that, and I thought the easiest, the quickest way to do it, ring up Dermy.
I think that she'll forgive you for not having the housing deposit as long as she doesn't have to spend a good month with Dermot Brereton, who is one of the more sort of out there characters of the AFL scene.
This week I realised I've got a few extra kilos that I probably should lose. I asked UK comedian Justin Morehouse, should I fight against it or accept it?
I think you have to accept it. It's like all these things in life. You know, once you learn to love yourself, Pablo, you're all right, aren't you? You're not fat anyway.
Oh, thank you.
You're just a little bit chunky. You're cuddly, Pablo.
Cuddly, I like it. Chunky, I don't know if chunky's a very affectionate word, is it?
Oh, it is, yeah. Okay. You're cuddly.
That'll make me help me sleep at night, I think.
Yeah. Well, you're struggling anyway because, you know, big people have sleep apnea, don't they? So that'll keep you awake.
And lastly, I was so excited this week to have my parents up in the Pilbara, and I knew that they'd be listening, but it didn't quite work out like that. On the Monday and the Tuesday, I was like, oh, it's going to be really good. Got my parents listening. Listenership's going to go up by at least two this week. I text my mum. I said, oh, are you listening? An hour later, she wrote back, sleeping. She didn't get up till 9. My show starts at 6.
It's pretty telling, really, that the man that they raised for 29 years, they can no longer stand the sound of his voice. Just, you know, it's a really sad sort of situation, but I've actually heard some stories that your old man had to unplug the radio and take it outside because the noise of his son's voice was so grating that he didn't think he could stay in the town a minute longer.